Distortion and power amplifiers can limit the performance of RF communication chains. Hey, I'm Heather, and today I'm introducing load control for modulation distortion measurements. Before we get into the measurement, let's talk a little bit about EVM. EVM is error vector magnitude, and it's the difference between your measured signal and the ideal reference signal. I have an example of a constellation diagram behind me. As we move towards higher order modulation schemes, the difference between the symbol points gets closer and closer together, so better EVM is needed to correctly demodulate these signals. In the frequency domain, nonlinear distortion is gonna look like these little shoulders right here. For a constellation diagram, it's gonna look like the symbol points on the edges get compressed towards the origin. EVM is challenging to measure because the system EVM is close to that of the DUT. Additionally, in the real world, the load conditions are changing, and so we need to be able to measure EVM as a function of varying load conditions. Keysight solves this problem with our arbitrary load control for modulation distortion application, which allows the user to present a wide range of impedance values to the DUT and measure distortion parameters under these varying load conditions with a modulated input signal. So here's our setup. We have the VXG, which provides our modulated input signal. That goes through the network analyzer to the input of our DUT, which is a power amplifier, and that's terminated with our passive mechanical tuner. This is a Mori tuner, but we work both with Focus and Mori microwave tuners, and that goes into the PNA, and the PNA controls the tuner as it moves to the different load points and measures the distortion parameters. For this measurement, we use a compact test signal, which is a statistically representative slice of a modulated input signal, and this allows us to have faster, repeatable measurements. Load pull measurements allow you to characterize a DUT under varying load conditions. For our application, the user can specify the impedance values that they want to measure. So here's our measurement result. We have power out versus power in as a function of the varying gamma, which is shown here on the Smith chart. We have gain versus power out and the bathtub characteristic, EVM versus power out, as a function of varying load impedances with a modulated input signal. Now with the same connection that you would use to measure S parameters, gain compression, and noise figure, you can measure the distortion characteristics of your amplifier under varying load conditions with a modulated input signal. To learn more, visit keysight.com or check out our Keysight hands-on videos.